celebrate an undisclosed birthday.
Happy birthday to Renee! That's the
Happy birthday! Happy birthday!
Thank you. bestowed upon them these favors. It was a lance against shield in the joust.
Lady Marie! it?
Oh, indeed, Your Highness.
Indeed.
And might we also trouble the good king for
some... Yes, fine. Ask him for some oranges.
Oh, but this is wise beyond her years. And now, the king of arms has declared the knights prepared for the combat.
Ah, very well.
His name shall be ever sung in the tales of legendary Olite, standard bearer, warrior, and the herald of Navarre. To arms, your knight! The realm unbound and the throne unfettered. All hail the Blue Knight! From the west comes the destroyer unchained. Let those who would cage him beware, for he is bold in his fury and terrible in his charge. Attend us, black and white knight! Say this to the miscreants and to the agents of unrest. No power on earth shall cast him aside, for he stands immovable as the rock that stands upon the shore. Grace us, red and yellow knight! A roar rises from the midst of battle, and the enemy wins as he approaches. Behold the lion, master of war, ride forth! Warrior in the kingdom, begin your search in Leon. Now see his talent swayed upon a mighty scale. Take the field, Green Knight! Houses, my queen, bred for war and accustomed to the dangers of battle, get here strong. Let us assuage your fears, good queen. For I ask of those here assembled, if there are any among you who lament this petition and its dangers, you are free to retire in honor and in gratitude for services already renowned by this throne.
Very well. Lord Marshal, perform the duties of your office, govern over the tournament.
Shall be my honor, your grace. Well, then, by all stations of my gift and skill, who shall claim this first challenge?
Thank you.
refreshment and await your next challenge.
Well, Lord Marshal, a fine beginning.
Indeed it is, Your Majesty. I now command.
Your Majesty, may I request that the champion of my own house have the honor of entering the field for the next challenge? For the nobles of Valiente grow restless.
Lord Marshal?
Yours is to command, Your Grace. Let us indeed test the mettle of the Blue Knight! And in answer to his challenge, the Yellow Knight! My Lord of Valiente, you may find glory in this day, but only if you defeat this noble veteran. Take your places, my lord. You shall answer.
The predator on the
What say you, my lords, my ladies? Would you see combat to the death?
Honestly, this combat is so hardly used to the joust. Yet, my guests have made their choice known. But the mortal wager was here made. The other knights shall not be stayed so. You can't blame me, my lord. And I'll be counted no less than the greatest of your house. My physician will attend you anon.
Well said, my queen.
And you, blue knight, tainted though your victory may be, it lies not tonight to recall grace from one so skilled. Rise, my lord, to the chairs of Aliente. Cedric, I have seen the face of war, and I know it well. And I know well the faces of the widow and the orphan that are the fruit of such things.
But your majesty, if I might be permitted, yours is to govern, true, yet surely the desire of your guest to see combat unyielding to let the hawk take its prey.
Gracious a host as she may be, Cedric. He says not of the pleasure of her guests, but as queen, anointed, and sovereign.
Okay. And well that may be, still as counselor to the queen, I will brook no lesson from one who serves in the role of royal umpire.
Umpire. Well then, if the queen's learned counselor would care to dispute my office in the tournament, or my willingness to wade into the fray, all he need do is leave his scarecrows perched at the queen's side and take him up.
Such is forbidden to members of my order.
Well, if it's not cowardly, it's at least convenient.
The power to wage war, or to allow death as a price of defeat at this tournament, lies not with you, Lord Cedric, or you, Lord Marshal, or any other man in this realm. It lies with the Queen, and the Queen alone, and I am Queen here!
I'm all for democracy!
Now, here is my command. Let any knight who would shy away from the fatal blow retire in honor and in peace. As for the others, Lord Marshal, let the combat go forward.
In mortal defiance, let us summon forth the knights of Leon and Santiago.
Thank you. having paid the child man the cashier for an insult long remembered.
These deacon Sabbath kids who win a gauntlet have been made a mortal wager. It tips the scale of charity and grace, and darkness reigns. Instead, let decorum and the weight of the tortoise as these prevail.
As you say, Your Majesty. No temple, your wish is granted. Attend us, my Lord of Castile! Another course.
to rule this field, and it is my command that your colors be struck from the list, and your name title blackened from the scroll of noble knights.
Your Majesty, a war is no place to punish a warrior.
You may fly the banner of your house, Cedric, but the power to make war lies not with him or any other in this realm save me.
Who shall tell the hawk when to take its prey, your Majesty? And as for you, King of Arms, neither striker nor commander shall you hold yourself in the Queen's presence.
We must govern over the tournament as we ourselves would be governed, with fairness and with honor. The way is written, and it falls not to us to change it. Lord Marshal, let the quarry answer the hawk.
What is it to be, my lord?
I charge you to call forth
the last. It is not in your power to refuse me, for knights are bound by oath to undertake such combat as this.
Insults and more have I suffered this day, and at the hands of a once noble house. But know this, dark horse of valiant age.
Thank you.
mightiest, and those whose banners have graced this field.
And yet a task remains. Attend to me, my lord. Chivalry requires that we pay homage. Ride forth, champion, and choose from among the ladies in the court one whom we shall call our queen of love.
Thank you.
elegant horses are the quest for a champion. The hundreds of knights in service to the Queen have only petitioned Her Majesty to hold a great tournament in order to find one who will stand as protector of the realm and defender of the throne. A warrior who wears the crest of the Queen and in all things the bringer of the Queen's grace or the instrument of the Queen's justice. In one passage of arms after another, these six knights have arisen as the finest in the art of war. From the western margins of the champions of Castilla, Santiago and Navarre, the Red Knight, the Black and White Knight, and the Internet! From the east, from the Titans of Leon, Peralola and Valiente, the Green Knight, the Red and Yellow Knight, and the Blue Knight! Well, the moment has arrived in which I must awaken your spirits. My lord, my ladies, tell me, have you two of the heroes who have come to see to toil in honor of your kingdoms? Give me your voices! Thank you enough, for the Queen has ordered all noble knights to draw nigh. Whenever the uncertainty of the blow as you run from his approaching terror, the DNA tremble beneath the halls of this noble house. Ride forth, Yellow Knight! play in the dark, my friends. For the lion sleeps with his eyes open. The wealth and dreams of a lifetime are swept away with a roar from the headless house of Castilla. Great is the grief of the noble houses whose banners have fallen and been crushed beneath the weight of the lion of Calahorra. Hear now the darkening roar of terror unhinged, and behold the young lion,
thank you.
this celebration, and I thank you all for inviting the nobles from near and far to join us. Your petition surprised and delighted me, for the crown has been without a champion since the passing of my father, the king. Your captains, take your leave. Our guests await the entertainment and the feast!
A gathering of the finest knights, each a champion in their own right.
Oh, champions indeed, and a handsome lot at that, and might I add a most eligible field?
Eligible? Why, whatever has that to do with the tournaments?
This is neither the time nor place.
Well, to your majesty, the realm at present without a champion, the crown of the king unworn, our queen alone, and with so many brave and true knights in attendance.
You might want to quit while you're ahead, old fellow.
If he was ahead, he might well do so. Cedric, I will brook none of your royal matchmaking this night. Let these princely knights entertain us on the field, and one be named as my defender alone, for no other bargains shall be struck here.
Indeed, your highness, forgive me, I merely meant to.
I pray you, serve me as you served my father, and forget not that I have inside me the blood of kings.
Of course, your majesty. Well, if there is to be no matchmaking this night, surely the queen will not gainsay a little merrymaking. A toast, my lady.
A toast, yes, wonderful. Come, my friends, let us raise our cups. To honor!
To honor!
Not quite, your majesty. I have had the finest fare in the kingdom prepared for our guests, and extra care is being taken to see that all is perfection.
Ah, perfection indeed. Very well. Lord Marshal, some entertainment for my guests.
Her majesty the queen is most proud of her staple prizes, Spanish horses, and among them are four of the most renowned in all the known world. It is her honor to present them to you now. Escalante performs the passage. At the center of the arena, we see Trojan Blades of the Oath. And once again, in an elegant farewell, the Basson fights my ladies gallant! Finally, mightiest of her Majesty's legendary stables, namesake of the mythic title, to uphold the sky, comes at us. As the peal of thunder breaks the mountains, so too the rumor and the approach of Atlas upon the field strike fear and awe into the heart of the enemy.
Yeah.
Green section!
ladies, while we are each of us here in the support of our own kingdom, we are also joined on a very special occasion, and that is we are celebrating the rule of Her Majesty, Doña Maria Isabella, who has ruled justly in the stead of her father. Let us now raise a cheer for Her Majesty the Queen. Hip hip! Indeed. We shall today wait and see which knight is mightiest, Her Majesty.
Why, thank you, and thank you, my friends, for raising your voices. And now, Cedric, what about the feast?
All is ready, Your Majesty.
And tell me, Cedric, how is it?
Majesty?
Oh, come, come, Cedric.
Just stop it.
What feast has ever been served in this great hall that our good Chancellor has not sampled freely?
Well, I may have had. You mock me, Your Highness.
No, oh, I jest with you. Oh, let the honor be yours, old friend.
Oh, very well. Then I say, let the feast now begin.